Alright, so as you can see from the title of this video, I'm gonna be showing you what a full day of eating looks like while I'm bulking. Before we get into the food intake, I just wanna kinda explain to you guys how I make up the foods that I'm going to be eating today. So what I do is I track my calories, and I use the app called MyFitnessPal to do this. Now, there's a bunch of different apps you can use to track your calories. I just prefer MyFitnessPal, and most people use MyFitnessPal. I recommend that you track your calories, and the best way to figure out how many calories you need to eat is go on an IIFYM calculator if it fits your macros. You can just type it on Google, IIFYM calculator, and you'll type in your height, weight, age, all these different things that they ask you for, your exercise expenditure, and you're pretty much going to get amount of calories that you need to eat to stay the same weight that you are currently. Now, they're going to give you how many calories you should eat on a bulk or a cut or a deficit, but I recommend that you just take that number, that base calorie number, and you add 500 calories to that. Once you've added the 500 calories to it, you go to MyFitnessPal and you go to your goals, you plug in that amount of calories, and there you go. Very, very simple. Okay, so for the first meal, we have 8 ounces of milk, we have 1 chocolate chip muffin, and then 6 eggs with 2 ounces of cheddar cheese on top of it. And then I'm gonna take my multivitamin and 12,000 IUs of vitamin D with my creatine. Now, what you guys are gonna notice is that my breakfast, lunch, and pre-workout meals are gonna be where I get my main bulk of calories, because I like to get most of my calories before the gym so that I get the benefit of having a lot of calories before the gym. You just feel stronger, fuller, everything like that. But for my pre-workout meal, you guys will also notice that I'm not gonna be eating an incredible amount of food, and I also eat my pre-workout meal like 2 to 3 hours before my workout, where a lot of people eat it maybe an hour before. For me, it's a while before, because I have to eat 4,000 calories for the day, so it's still gonna be a pretty decently sized meal. And yeah, trying to get 4,000 calories, which is my goal for the day, is very hard for me personally, so I can't eat chicken, broccoli, and rice. I have to throw in some muffins, some cheese, and things like that. So I'm gonna enjoy this right now, and then I'll catch you guys for lunch. All right, so for the second meal of the day, we're gonna be doing one of my favorite bulk foods of all time, these Bertolli frozen meal things. This is a chicken Florentine version. These guys, I'm telling you, they're incredible. And when they're on sale, they're like, I think $2 for one of them, maybe $3. So you're honestly getting a steal on it. Definitely worth it. If they have these in your local grocery store, definitely go check them out. Really, really good. So I'm gonna make this up right now. And for me, these are actually really, really easy to eat. So if you don't really have the biggest appetite, these things are actually really, really good. They have a good amount of fat in them. And when you're trying to bulk up and you don't really have a good appetite, then you're not going to be able to get as many carbs because they're harder to eat. So what you can do in exchange for that is just eat a little bit more fat, which is what I tend to do. So yeah, I'm going to heat this up right now and kill it. Super excited to eat this. All right, so it's time for my pre-workout meal right now. I hate getting all my protein in towards the end of the day. In the past, I've done it where I kind of lack on my protein all day, and then at nighttime, I just pound a bunch of egg whites and protein shakes. I'm not really about that now, so I try to split it up throughout the day so I can enjoy some good tasting stuff towards the nighttime as well. So what I'm going to do right now for my pre-workout meal is a protein shake. So what I'm going to be putting in there is some reduced fat milk. I'm gonna put probably right around 16 ounces of that. And then we're gonna do some peanut butter. Just some normal Skippy peanut butter, 2 tablespoons of that. All right, so this right here is a new blender, so we're gonna find out right now if it works well. I'm hoping that it does. Our next ingredient is gonna be our protein. Gotta have your protein for a protein shake. So we're gonna do 1.5 scoops of this. 1.5 scoops. Then we're gonna throw in some mint chocolate chip ice cream, right around 1 serving of that. The last thing that we're gonna throw in here is some ice. Now, I see a lot of people really mess up on their protein shakes and not put ice in there. This definitely helps give it like a good consistency, keeps it nice and cold. So I always put ice in there. Hopefully this blender actually blends the ice up, because my last one didn't. I'm gonna enjoy this shake, and then I'm gonna head over to the gym. I'm gonna be hitting a pull day today. Probably gonna hit like a conventional PR, hopefully. And then, I don't know, we'll see what I do. I might do something beltless after that, and then just a little bit of back hypertrophy. But tomorrow I'm gonna be going in and training with a friend, and he wanted to hit back, so I'm not gonna be doing too much of that, or really any biceps. So yeah. The next clip you guys are going to see is some deadlifts, and then I'm going to catch back up with you guys later, and we're going to get a post-workout meal in.
side. I must have called a thousand times to tell you I'm sorry
for everything that I've done.
But when I call, you never seem to be home.
Let's go. I call but you don't answer, so I write this open letter. When I left, the world was broken, I just hope it's gotten better. You argue who's the greatest, I left quotes for y'all to measure. Y'all were focused on who's clever, I was focused on forever. Back when I would rock the hand-me-downs with holes inside my sweater. Thrift store shopping like I dove inside some treasure. Way before the Ben Haggerty's on these magazines, I was an average teen, I thinking about this thing called rap. Cause there's this thing called white, and there's this thing called black, and there's this thing called life, and I think we're all attached. It's funny how my train of thought runs on these things called tracks. Marty McFly, I'm in the future, try and bring y'all back. Pick it up and slam it down, that's just how the game goes. Telephone, telephone, I just hear the same tones. Where I'm from, it's not too often that we see them rainbows. So we let the rain flow, then we change clothes.
There's such a difference between us and a million
miles. That's right,
miles.
We gonna get him with this one.
This just be a hobby. 5 whole hours they've been waiting in the lobby. They calling me a hero and I'm thinking, how could I be? All I wanted was a million and a two-door Maserati. But somewhere in my stride, we just started changing lives. You think I'm changing yours, but you really changing mine. From here to overseas, they put belief in my designs. It's getting deep, I feel the world is trying to sneak inside my mind. It's harder to define than artistry and rhyme. It seems like our journey is partially divine. I still have days where it isn't all sublime. Even though I'm on the grind, I gotta slow up for the signs. And recently I'm seeing that it's more than just emceeing. Where my homie has a son, but these court orders just to see him. A generation troubled and I just wanna free him before machines are looking at human beings inside a museum.
I just got back from the gym about an hour and a half ago, and I'm absolutely starving right now. As you guys have seen today, I've eaten really, really big meals. Most of the time, I'll actually space all this, like, 4,000 calories up in about six meals, usually at least five, but today, I mean, I got done, and this is my fourth meal right here. What I'm gonna do for my last meal today, which is going to end off my macros pretty much, is three servings of pasta right here, and then I'm gonna also eat three of these like Mott's apple sauces right after. Has some pretty good micros in here. These taste really good. Some good simple carbs. So I'm gonna kill this right now. And then I'm probably gonna, just to get like my last 200-300 calories, I'll probably eat like some pretzels or like a bagel or something like that later. I hope you guys have learned from this video that you don't have to eat all these specific foods that like bodybuilders eat. Like I see all the time, people think they have to eat chicken, rice, and broccoli, kind of like I said earlier. I mean, if you're eating a certain amount of calories, you can, and you have a certain amount of macros, you can really play with that and eat as much as you, or eat as many different types of foods as you want to in that macro and calorie goal. People have an issue when they're going over their macros, so like if they're trying to cut and they're eating a bunch of pasta, yes, it's a problem, and you should probably eat rice cakes that are less calories. I don't know. In my opinion, I'm just saying you can eat what you want to eat if you have a specific calorie and macro goal, and you're hitting your micronutrients by, you know, some applesauce, some multivitamins, and I also ate, like, some strawberries and blueberries off camera that you guys didn't see, but I got in my micros for the day, basically. So yeah, just make sure you guys get your micronutrients in, make sure you guys track your calories, even if you're on a bulk, if you're not really sure how many calories you really need for the day and you're not very familiar with macros. And that's really all the advice I have on this. So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video.